In the last few weeks, Reiza were pretty actively producing new content for Automobilista 2 and therefore pushing it further to its final state. However, this time, they not only handed us some nice improvements, but also provided us with an insight for what is planned for the next weeks via a roadmap. So let's go straight over the changes of the new update and theorize about a rather interesting picture which can be found there at the end. The first few changes are all somewhat connected to the time trial mode, which has now finally been enabled and lets us compete against each other on hot lap sessions. And for those of you who are not too familiar with this, the track conditions are always at an optimum and stay the same for the whole session. Additionally, your car's tire temperatures, hence also the pressures, and the damage you potentially could get, all reset after you cross the start-finish line. This allows you to start every lap under the same conditions, and you really can limit test some corners, since the damage can safely be ignored. However, if you made a mistake and want to restart instantly, you can just choose the reset session or restart session option to be ported back to a set starting position. Alongside the time trial mode came also an adjustment to the cutting logic of AMS2. Before this patch, the game would always invalidate your next lap time if you have to cut the track to gain an advantage for the starting straight at the same distance percentage before the start-finish line. Now, this percentage has been tweaked to 5% in practice sessions, 10% in qualifying sessions, and 15% for time trial sessions. So, in short, you are allowed to cut closer to the start-finish line in practice sessions than in qualifying or time trial sessions, which could, in some instances, lead to potentially slightly faster lap times at a few circuits in practice sessions. In the last update, Reiza announced to introduce further improvements to AMS2's force feedback and an entirely new feature in the upcoming patches. And this is exactly what they did this time. A tire scrub feature was added to the game and is now enabled under the FX slider in the force feedback settings, but only if you are running on the new default profile. A minimum force setting was also added, but is disabled by default. When enabled, it's trying to enhance your force feedback to never fall below a set threshold, which may be useful if you want to have a better feel for your car when driving in a straight line, for example, as there are barely any forces involved. So this was basically it for the 0.8.7.1 update, but as promised in the beginning, we are now going to take a closer look at Reiza's new roadmap, and especially at a certain picture they added at the very end. First and foremost, if you're interested in AMS2, but are not sure yet whether it will be worth its money or not, be aware that with next week's 0.9 update, the game's price will also be increased from 25 to 45 euros. Secondly, Reiza stated that the release of the multiplayer ratings will be pushed back a bit, since they are currently investigating multiple issues with the netcode, as some strange collisions are currently happening, where, according to the server, two cars touched, even though they never did on neither of the driver's clients, which is, to be honest, also the main reason why I'm currently avoiding the multiplayer and rather race the AI instead. Next on, a few new cars and a new layout for the Quail Army circuit in South Africa were teased, with the cars being a Brazilian endurance prototype by the name of Sigma P1, the Lotus 72D, the McLaren M23, and finally the Brabham BT44, which were, apart from the Sigma P1 of course, or rather successful at one point in Formula 1. Lastly, this picture can be found at the very bottom of the new roadmap. It features a car on a dark circuit. Now, the only hints are the rear lights and the fences on the left side of the track. These lights look rather familiar to me, as I coincidentally did a night race in ACC not too long ago and was stuck behind a specific car, which happened to be the Porsche 911 GT3 R, which has ridiculously similar rear lights. Now, for the track, we can see that this photo was most likely taken on a high-speed straight, judging by the motion blur and assuming no additional filters were applied to the image. Now, a few people already guessed that it's the Nordschleife, and I'm also leaning into the same direction, because the track looks like it's very narrow and the fences could very well be the ones at the back straight here. In the end, I'm sure that the car is actually the Porsche 911 GT3 R, and also fairly certain that the track is the Nordschleife. Now, this was basically it for this video, and if you want to be informed about future updates and what they change, or want more sim racing content in general, be sure to hit the subscribe button in order to not miss anything. And with that said, I'll catch you in the next one. Cheers!